Happy holidays. It's the winter time, you cuddled up next to the fire, but more importantly, it's the end of the year. My favorite time of the year, because I get to reflect on all the movies that came out. And this year, there were a lot, and there were a lot of good ones. Today we're going to talk about my favorite movies of 2022, and we're just going to get right into it. So coming up on top is going to be my man, my main man. Now, this movie probably won't stay on my top five list. There are a few other movies that I'd like to see that came out this year that I think could probably edge it out. But I'll make this one a little brief since I did already talk about it in a different video. That's right here. Personally, I just feel that Matt Reeves and every other executive and producer, besides him being the director, just did a phenomenal job with this movie. Casting aside, I think that the cinematography, the way it's written, and the slow burn just gives it that really nice detective noir feel, which I know is what it was going for, and I think it just knocks it out of the park completely. But the cast itself is probably my favorite thing about this movie. People like Paul Dano as the Riddler and Robert Pattinson as Batman, Zoe Kravitz as Catwoman and such. But honestly, my favorite is Jeffrey Wright as Gordon. I think he plays that character really well, very funnily also. And I think the movie itself is just a very good soft origin story. It's obviously take place during year two, so it's not a complete origin. The thing is, about Batman, everybody gets it. You know, his story and his past is virtually the same depending on what adaptation you read or watch. And I think that it's okay that we get it, that we know Batman's parents. We get some of his past, but we don't get all of it. And I think that that works really well into giving some mystery still within his character, even though it is sort of like an origin. But I think it's done very well. The music and the editing and the mixing behind it is also really, it's a good movie. I love it. To me, it's tens across the board. I love every second of it. I've watched it at least 6 or 7 times this year since it's come out. And I love it. I love the movie so much. I'm biased on it because I like Matt Reeves' previous work, and I'm just in love with Robert Pattinson. So now, well, I do love it. It's just not my favorite of this year. Now, Nope is a pretty good damn movie. It's a big ol' yep from me. I enjoy this movie quite a lot. And I really didn't know what to expect coming into it, honestly, because I thought Get Out was a very good masterclass showing of a directorial debut. But then when Us came out, I wasn't really f***ing with Us. And even more recently, I've seen it after watching Nope. And I still doesn't tickle my fancy all that much. Nope, honestly, is my favorite of the three, probably the superior, just because the acting alone, I think all of the acting in this movie is done fantastically well. Steven Yeun's character is just very well written, and is just a good old American. I do like how this movie can be interpreted a few different ways. I'm sure that Jordan Peele has his own way that he sees the movie, you know, showing different ways with relationships with unknown entities, and not being aliens specifically like in this movie, but even humans and animals, because they touch on that a lot also. Trust is something that even if you think you've got it, it's never a for sure thing. You can see how you can never hold on to it, and you can see the arrogance that humans can go through being in Steven Yeun's character as somebody that has seen tragedy before him and has scarred the people around him, and even him himself can keep falling into these tendencies, you know, tragedy after tragedy. Humans just kind of suck. I think Peele did a really good job with directing the actors in this movie, which sounds kind of weird. Not that he was ever necessarily bad about it beforehand. I think that he just has a specific vision for this movie, and I think he did a really nice job with it, just making sure that everybody stays on track, everybody's on one parallel thing, And visually, this movie is very beautifully directed and beautifully shot. I do hope we get to see Kiki Palmer in more things coming up. She's a very good actress. And this is the first time, really, that she's been in something this, not really mainstream, but almost blockbustery. And I don't know where she's been hiding at, but I'd like to see her in more. It's shot beautifully. There's a great story behind it. There's a great message. It's a very powerful movie. Visuals are tens across the board. Great storytelling. Like I said, I can go on and on about this movie. While I will say that I think people get a little too caught up in smaller details. There was a lot of people that talked online about how they didn't understand the movie or they didn't get the monkey scene. And I don't know. I think you just need to watch more movies. But while I love Nope, it just can't be my favorite.
We won't call it quits. We'll call it the start.
Now this right here is probably my sleeper hit of the year. I saw this movie only about a week or two ago at this point while I was writing this script and I had to move some things around. It's just a very emotional and impactful, just hurtful, raw story from everybody that's in just all the main characters and all the main casting. Just, you gotta feel bad for every single one of these people. Their acting just brings them and elevates this this feeling that you get for all of these characters and just makes you care for them that much more, actually seeing the physical presence on screen from all of them. For people that don't know anything about this movie, because it is kind of unknown, it is on HBO Max now. It is a very slow burn back and forth between two very different types of people and types of physical characters. Someone who wants more and can't accept the life that they've been chosen with and that they don't want to be a part of anymore. And somebody that is completely content with the simplicity behind their life. They are opposed by each other, and it's a really good back and forth of just not understanding and wanting more but can't having it. Basically, it's just about a movie of a guy that doesn't like this guy anymore, and he doesn't want to be friends, so they fight. They bicker back and forth after they take drastic measures towards each other, and you finally get the metaphor, you get what the movie's about. And by the end of it, they basically rip each other of the things that they love, that they have on these small little island, and they finally realize that this is something that's probably destined to go on for forever. Even if it stops for now, it's always bound to start back up again. And it's a really good metaphor for war, and it takes place during the Ireland-English War. Don't quote me on that, I'm probably fucking lying, but it's a metaphor for war, basically. You get it by the end of the movie, and it's beautifully well done. You see all the emotion. It basically, by all characters, carries by what it feels like two countries going at head with each other. It's just a fantastic piece of art. If you like slow burns and you like good storytelling, 110% I recommend this movie. Still not my favorite though. Robert Eggers is my guy. He's probably my favorite director of this current generation, filmmaking. He's fantastic. I love him so much. He recently directed Lighthouse, but he just knocks it out of the park with this Nordic revenge story. The visual storytelling alone that he does and can pull off is always amazes me. The work that he puts into this movie, especially with the sensitive timing that it is, making sure things are accurate and everything looks like it should have, being the time period that they're in, is amazing. I've listened to the commentary track, the director's commentary track that comes with the 4K. It's really good to see some insight on how directing as a whole is done. The two leads, being Alexander Skarsgård and Anya Taylor-Joy, are fantastic. They play off each other really well, I think. And the emotion that they both can bring, one that's just a barbaric Viking, his physical presence is just a massive and done very well. This revenge story is none like other. During this vicious, barbaric era, there were no good guys, Everybody did shady, scummy, nasty, vile things during this time. And Robert Eggers does a really good job at depicting that. There's just nobody to root for in this movie. But I think that that helps play into it, showing an accurate description. This one does have more of a faster pace because it is a bigger budget. And I haven't been disappointed with what he does. He does it really well. Now, I really did have my heart set on this being my favorite movie of the year. And it was at first. Until I saw
Everything, Everywhere, All at Once. This movie made me cry like a This movie is very emotional from everything across the board. It just excels. The cast, the four leads that all got nominated for their own Oscars in their own category, is kind of nuts for a movie like this. Which, this isn't even the only movie that did that. Banshees also did that. So this has just been a good year for movies. I'm happy. But something that this movie does better than every other movie I saw this year was it made me feel. This is a movie that just excels on everything across the board. It's got good writing. It's got good cinematography. The acting is... The attention to details, the little things that happen, the funny remarks. This movie is dramatic, it's funny, it's sad, it just hits everything across the board. This movie that's not just about fitting in, not just about making sure that you made the right decisions in life or feeling lesser of yourself because you feel like you're not in the right position, you feel like you haven't done the right things. This movie does a really good job of showing to be appreciative of what you have and the people around you. And as long as you've got people around you that you love and that love you in return, everything could be all right. I talk about this movie a lot over the last year because I believe it came out pretty early in 2020. So you've probably seen me talk about it multiple times, and I just love this movie. It does a lot of right. It's weird. It's weird, but it's also grounded, and it's not a complex type of story. It's very relatable to a lot of different people in a lot of different situations. Then there's just never a dull moment in this movie to little details that happen, like the Super Smash Bros. Sound. Or line deliveries that are gonna live on through the next decade. It's got everything. It's got a little bit of everything. And that is why Everything Everywhere All at Once is my movie of the year. And why I love cinema in general.